Hello students, welcome to Little Officers. Welcome to another session on concepts and terminology. In this particular video, I am going to discuss about currency swap. If you are a newspaper reader, you often come across this word. India has signed a deal, currency swap deal, with its neighbors or with any other country. This particular term, that is currency swap, has been in the news. It will be in the news. Okay. So let us understand the concept related to it. And let us see how it is going to help us. Okay, so let us enter. So what is the meaning of currency swap? What is the meaning of swap? Swap karne ka matlab kya hai? Like exchanging. Okay, now to understand this, we have to understand the concept of international trade, how it happens. See, international trade, whenever we buy or we export or we import some goods, what we generally do? We do not do that like export or import in the local currency, because local currency, Indian currency, is not accepted globally. Like convertibility is completely not there and it is not accepted completely. And no, countries which are selling us or which are buying from us, they pay us in terms of dollar or in terms of euros, and similarly they also demand the money in terms of dollar or euros. So when we do the trading like exports or imports, what we are doing? We are doing through a third currency, which is, we say in the basket, like hot currency, which is more in demand in the global economy. So such currencies are, which are put in the basket, like it may be US dollar, it may be euro or pound sterling or Japanese yen, such sort of things. Okay. Now, what is the problem with this? When we are doing with the third currency, suppose say on one side you have India, okay, and other side suppose say Sri Lanka. When these two countries are engaging in the trade, what happens? India, it does not pay in terms of rupees to the Sri Lanka, and Sri Lanka does not pay in terms of Sri Lankan rupee. Rather, what it does, India converts Indian rupee into dollar, and that dollar will be paid to the, it will be paid to the Sri Lanka. Similarly, Sri Lanka also, whenever it wants to pay money to India, it will convert, it will buy dollar, okay, from the market using its currency or gold, then that dollar will be paid to it. So what is happening? Two times there is exchange. As a result, there is foreign exchange burden. So a lot of money we are giving in terms of exchange, buying it. And as a result of this demand, even the currency value of local currency value also diminishes, depreciates. So to avoid such problems, countries like bilateral relations, jin countries ke saath achha hai, jin ke saath friendly relations hai, such countries generally enter into an agreement known as currency swap. So here what we do, it is an arrangement, it is an agreement between two friendly countries where they will start doing their trade in the local currency. For example, India is buying something from Bangladesh. So rather than paying Bangladesh in dollar, we will pay in Indian rupee or Bangladesh rupee. Similarly, vice versa for Bangladesh. Thereby what we are doing, we are exchanging the currencies and we are avoiding the third currency. Lekin, yahan par ek doubt ho sakta hai. Sir, if it is so, then how can we come to that conclusion, like what is the value of Indian rupee when we compare it with Bangladesh, and similarly vice versa? For that, what they do, they will have a predetermined agreement. Like for example, today Indian rupee, suppose say for $1, like $1, let us say 70 rupees, this is the exchange rate. Similarly, for Bangladesh or Sri Lankan rupee, suppose say 90 rupees. I'm just giving the random numbers, not the exact ones according to the exchange rates. What will happen? Now it is determined on this day, $1, 70 Indian rupees or 90 Sri Lankan rupees. Then for the entire term, entire period in which this agreement is going to be in force, and whatever the amount they have predetermined, suppose say 1000 crores or 100 crores, some sort of money, like, or $10 million. So that much of amount to that much of time period, they are going to exchange in the local currency using this predetermined exchange rate of exchange. So in future, if the currency value depreciates or appreciates, if it is going to change with the respect to the exchange rate, that is not going to affect this agreement. So that is how it is going to help us. I repeat, what is the currency swap? Between two countries, while doing the trade, while doing any other international transactions, what we will be doing? We will be having such transactions in the local currencies, in the domestic currencies, and avoiding the third currency. Thereby, we are saving the exchange rate that we are giving. At the same time, the more dollar demand, we are reducing it. So your domestic market currency, it will have the confidence, okay? Its value will increase in the global level. So these are all the points that we can capture from here. Now, let us look at what are the advantages by doing it. The first advantage, as I said, there won't be third currency involvement as we are doing it in the local currencies. As a result, we don't have to worry about exchange, like rate of exchange, future mein kya hoga, abhi kitna hai, past mein kaise tha. So we don't have to worry about it. Future mein, even if it is going to increase or reduce, we have already predetermined exchange rate. Second, improves confidence in the local market. When you are doing in the local currency, it is going to improve confidence in the local market. So that is the second advantage. Third advantage, it enables the agreed amount, like I said, 100 crore or 1000 crore or $10 million or so, amount of capital being available to that country. So there is an assurity, because we are signing an agreement, so there is an assurity for next 2 years, this much of money we will be having availability. So that confidence will be there. Then it will be bringing down the cost of capital. At the same time, cost of capital in the sense when the FDA is coming to India or any other country, then the exchange rate is going to cost us some. That will be reduced. At the same time, it will also give, like, while assessing this foreign capital market, you will be having an advantage. Okay, since you are not demanding the third currency in a much more terms. Then the final point is, it aids in bringing greater stability, the financial stability, to the foreign exchange and capital markets. As a result, these local domestic markets, they will have the confidence and they don't have to worry about these exchange vagaries or exchange variations. So this is another advantage. Okay, I hope this session is useful to you. Do like, share and subscribe, and share these videos among your peers. Thank you very much.